Hi, welcome. Thank you for your attendance for another live show at the Anarchic Chick Place. That's this channel, that's where you are, and you have arrived. Thank you. You know you're awesome, so I really don't need to tell you. You know what I'm saying? Basically, you guys are helping me out here with the title, and thanks to YouTube. There is a certain way that you can change the title name. I like that because I do, sometimes have different ideas. So the turn, the no host stream title, the title name sucks title. How about annoying and irrelevant as the title? Call it taste my ass hair. Call it bruh. Call it that might get her another car. Or call it party on. Lauren, that's a really cute picture, by the way. The ponies and the look. Definitely have that stardom going on for you, stardom look going on for you. Way to go. All right. So you guys are probably wondering, what is this show about? Or what are her intentions for the show? And to what would it be about for the audience? And basically, it's about inflatable mascots. Inflatable mascots. We will be discussing how they work and how effective they really are for the audience at a game of some type, a sporting event, a sports game for the audience, for the fans. I know as much as you guys want to watch that again, you certainly can on the Anarchic Chick channel. It's under the shorts section. So you can definitely see that again. I watch it at least twice a day, only because it's so funny. And also because, it's a short and we all like those. Just a couple more ideas for the title are, is there a point to this? And Mike Jones is saying that it could be you need rehab and psych meds. I want to say they're all good titles, but I am still coming up with the actual perfect title for this show.
Fuck that last one.
Fuck that last one. That now, that's a good one. Fuck that last show, because from here on out, the shows are going to be way cooler, way more entertaining, and way more educating. Chili bail hearing bandwagon. I did not. And if he did bail out or not, I don't really GAS. give a shite. Mike Jones must be real cool, says Sarsaparilla Soda Pop. Sounds like a bad 50s band. Cooler, a house are way cooler too. Anyways, okay. So as you saw there, that was the air stuff, which is the Orlando Magic mini mascot to stuff, regular stuff.
Yeah, the best mascot in the motherfucking NBA.
They do have the best colors, which are actually my favorite. The lime green, it has yellow and pink. Very bright. They really do stand out. And I'll show you exactly what I'm talking about. Right here on the screen. Right here on the Anarchy Chick Show. You're going to love this one. Can you guys hear this? Okay, I have a question in the audience, and I would like to address that. And that's coming from Big Brick with two C's. His question is very intelligently asked, is what is this? Well, what this is the NBA mascots inflatables dancing at the 2013 NBA All-Star Game. I'm sure there have been many others since then, but this was the one that I could find. And I just think they're so cool and very, you know, hip. I am trying not to laugh maniacally, like I was earlier. And so that's why it's a good thing that I did view it prior to watching it here with you again. It is relevant, okay? And I'll tell you why. Because we're going to have a little bit of education. And if anybody wants to come up and contest that with me, you're welcome to, Mr. Legit Neanderthal. Yeah. So why don't you get your ass up here and we'll sort this out. You want to do that? How about that, huh? Bring it then, bish. You wish you could swish on me, bish. That's your one wish. Here you go. Click on that, bish. So no, you're wrong. I'm right. Click on it. Okay. Yeah, a little bit more.
The
Fantastic. That was cool. I hope that you were attentively watching the different movements that the Inflatables were able to make, because I was like, well, how do they do that? That's very cool. I wonder what is going on there. And if you're wondering the same, you'll be interested in watching this. And that's how you do it, guys. That's exactly how it is done. So you too can become a mascot if you choose to at any of these particular sports events that maybe you would be able to land a job. That'd be pretty cool, especially doing some splits and cartwheels and falling face down like you're, you know, you own the court, which is really cool because this guy seems to really know how to own.
Now 3.5 seconds to go. Curry with Poe on him and Redick right there forming the wall. Even if it goes in. Oh, it did, but it will not count. They waved it off.
They're going to take a look at this.
Well, sure they are.
Oh, my goodness.
Former Philadelphia High School Basketball Player of the Year. I don't think he.
No. He didn't get it off.
No, Ken Maurer called it.
Green weaving, trying to get the shot up. No call that way. Curry flings it the other way. And he got it! What a turnaround! Curry the three!
A miraculous shot by Curry, the length of the floor for three.
And how about Curry from the other side, from 70 plus feet, ending the third.
Will go, and at the end of the first quarter.
Okay, did he say 70 plus feet? Wow, that's amazing. Steph Curry, guys, the greatest basketball shooter at this time. Wow, just awesome. Just an awesome player, very handsome, very enjoyable to watch. So yeah, Golden State, man, all the way with Steph Curry. Very cool guy, very down to earth, has a nice family. 70 plus feet, I mean, that's way past the half court. He's amazing, and he hasn't just done it once. It's many times, which is just, oh man, love this guy.
That went in, but it won't count.
But why should we be surprised? Can't score. Time for Curry from half court. It's gone! He banks it in!
Are you kidding me?
He made one at the end of the first that didn't count. This one's good.
Really? He was mad at himself at the end of the first quarter that he didn't shoot it in time as he made it. He made sure this time. He sized it up and goes glass. Oh, you've got to be kidding.
Three-pointer number 200 on the season for Steph Curry, the first NBA player ever with 200 threes for four straight years, and he does it in style, banking it in to end the half. Toyota halftime coming up.
2 seconds to work with. Curry from mid-court. It's good!
Yeah, I guess they need some better defense past the half court a little more when he's playing. But everybody knows that he is the best basketball shooter at this time.
Ever.
Right, because he is the only to have 200 three-point shots.
Yeah, he was the first to have 200 three-pointers in a season. And since that season, he has had 200-plus every season.
For 4 years. Or, well, I don't know, how old is this video? Oh, let's see. Just an amazing dude. And, you know, he's practicing these shots, you know, daily, I'm sure. The very first time he made one at half court, he was probably surprised himself. I mean, unless he literally just practices them. I doubt that he just is, you know, haphazardly, accidentally making them. And they're effortless and they're swishes. It's not even like, you know, bounced off the backboard, bounced around the rim, and then it's all the way. One straight shot. Hey, sweet, who's the bully? I'm about to go off right now. Tell me, because I need to know. This is not acceptable. He needs to know. STL, what's going on, buddy? You tell Paige I said hey. And also, Ross Kahn, hi. Good to see you there. Freaks is here. Hello. Freaks loves bowling. Most definitely is the top game for Freaks. McNuggets are pretty tasty. I mean, there is the Nuggets NBA. Maybe you like, you know, NBA team. Maybe you like that team. Sure. But
reigning champions.
Mm-hmm. LSU shells. They have bullies on their team. Ooh. Yeah, that rubs me the wrong way, sweet. It really does. Things, you know, hearing things like that is disappointing and for all mankind. Again.
The clock from mid-court. Curry goes!
Oh,
he backed it home!
Well, he's been doing nice things.
We are watching a player who is otherworldly.
He's a delicate fellow.
Curry will just dribble it out. And the fans are also obviously aware of Paul George being 1 point away.
Oh! Mills from deep. Missed it wide right. And Curry from 65. He backed it in! And he waved it off.
Well, that was going to
replay because it's at 0-0.
When you're scrambling for the ball, if Steph Curry's in the vicinity, get away from it. Let him take it because he knows how to hit shots past half.
2 seconds.
3 seconds left.
Steph from 75.
He didn't get it
and
off
he got
time.
It.
I don't think he got it off in time.
It was late.
Oh, that's yeah.
The shot was still nice.
That sucks, man.
Steve Kerr says, well, let's go to replay and see, but it will not count. He had to go around two men. That was the problem.
Watch the red light, and it's still in his hands.
I don't even think they tried.
Double clutch. Off the rim. Curry has time. 3 seconds. Curry from half court. Oh, he puts it in at the buzzer.
Is right at the you know, right at the nick of time, right at crunch time. That's when he is able to give it his best shot. Kind of like, you know, he's good with deadlines, probably. It pumps him up. It gives him that motivation to do better. Aussie Angel, what's going on there? How you doing? What else can we discuss? Oh, yeah. One more thing here. Got one more show off a little bit.
And mouth guards so expensive, it'll make you sick. These are the stupidly expensive things NBA players own. And LaMelo Ball, he made a purchase so stupidly expensive, he had to hide it from his dad. This all went down back in 2020. Before LaMelo even signed a deal with the NBA, he decided to hit up AP the jeweler to create a 14-karat white gold VVS honeycomb diamond grill. Damn, that was a mouthful. And as soon as LaMelo put this grill in his mouth, he had to show everyone what's popping.
Yes, sir.
That is badass.
Ooh, the drip, the ice. Ah, I'm over here catching a cold. Achoo. But here's what's crazy, man. LaMelo hadn't got a single check from the NBA, and he blew $40,000 on this. Now, at this point, his dad still had no idea. But lucky for us, LeVar found out about all of this wasted money on live TV.
Have you seen the grill that LaMelo got, the full VVS diamond grill in his mouth?
He got a grill in his mouth?
He does.
What are you talking about?
He got a full VVS diamond top and bottom grill for his teeth. Have you seen that?
I have not seen that.
Hold up. No. This man is straight snitching. Tell LeVar every little detail. I'm disgusted. You should be ashamed of yourself.
Yeah.
And what do you know? It turns out people agree with me. Because the comments ragged on this dude so hard, he was literally losing sleep over it. So the next time he saw LaMelo, the man had to try and clear his name.
I talked to your dad yesterday, and I told him about your grill that you got the other day, and I had folks calling me a snitch. Do you think, am I considered a snitch for, like, you know, breaking that news to him?
I mean, the whole internet seen it, so I don't see how you would be a snitch. And at the end of the day, I'm a grown man. Get what I want, do what I want.
Was that your first big purchase with the NBA contract?
Nah, I don't spend my NBA money. I'm smarter than that, man.
You don't spend NBA money. Well, whose money are you spending? You got a $200,000 Lambo, a $40,000 grill, and a diamond chain for your dog. That's not even a joke. He actually did that. This man's dog is living like Quavo. God damn it. That's how a rookie spends his money. What about an NBA legend? Well, after LeBron James closed out 2020 winning his fourth championship, he ended up feeling nothing but disappointment. See, because of the pandemic, LeBron literally wasn't allowed to throw parties or have a championship parade. And if you know LeBron, the man always goes crazy after winning a ring. So this was a huge disappointment. And for the next 2 months, LeBron sat and tried to come up with the perfect celebration for his win. And there was one thing that he just couldn't get off his mind. The Porsche 918 Spyder. The fastest accelerating car in the whole fucking world. But there was one stupidly expensive problem. Porsche actually stopped making this car, and all the models were sold out. That meant that no one could buy this car, not even LeBron. And since it's the fastest car in the world, man, ain't nobody want to sell it. So LeBron had to bribe someone to give up their Porsche 918. And what he ended up paying to get this car will make you sick. This Porsche should have cost LeBron $845,000. But instead, it cost him $2.2 million. I don't care how bad he wanted this car. This man is literally paying the price of two for one. And unlike LaMelo, LeBron really thought twice before doing something stupid like this.
Yeah.
Because he's got most of his money wrapped up in investments.
Really?
So $2.2 million is a lot of money. It is more than he was trying to drop. But then, on one crisp LA morning, his phone rang. And it was the Lakers. They had a deal ready for him that he couldn't refuse. 2 years for $85 million. Damn, this right here was the stupid excuse he needed. So LeBron had no choice. He knew he had to send it. And that's when he went out and copped his brand new Porsche 918 Spyder, all black. This car is faster 0 to 60 than any Bugatti, Lamborghini, or McLaren. And LeBron may be king of the court, but now he's also king of the streets. And as soon as he saw cameras rolling while he was driving, he smoked everybody on the road. Now, we all want crazy cars like this, right? But making money like LeBron is damn near impossible for us. Or is it? Because it turns out, not everyone has to work to get a car like that. Some people are just friends with James Harden. Yeah, being friends with NBA players is a pretty high-paying job. What, you don't believe me? Well, one of Harden's good friends is Lil Baby, and they've been seen hanging out a lot recently. And one of those times was Lil Baby's 26th birthday. Harden was one of 100 plus guests, but he came in with the bag, literally.
Give me a Prada bag because he's proud of me. Full of honey buns. With a honey bun. You know what I'm saying? Man, I got serious.
Man, I want to brag with a honey bun and a honey bun.
You got two rich, man?
Two rich in one day, man.
And he proud of
you.
Hey, he proud of me because he's proud of me, man.
He's proud of you.
Honey bun.
They're
going to have to catch up tomorrow. They're gonna have to catch up tomorrow.
Harden really came in with a $300,000 Prada bag filled with $100,000 in cash and topped it off with a $200,000 Richard Mille watch. Jesus. But you know what really caught my eye? All those damn honey buns. The hell you need that many honey buns for? It's ridiculous. But there's actually a reason why James Harden showered Lil Baby with all these gifts. Turns out, James Harden is hooking up everyone who drops a like and subscribes to the channel. Yeah, that's right. James Harden's handing out honey buns and Richard Mills. And I know you want one, so what are you doing? But anyways, Lil Baby is subscribed to Rebound, and that's because he knows what's up. Unfortunately, some people haven't subscribed yet, and one of them is PJ Tucker. And since he's not subscribed, he's not getting anything for free. And lately, he's been struggling with a scary, stupidly expensive addiction. An addiction so powerful, he sunk millions of dollars into it. The man's got a serious problem. PJ Tucker just can't stop buying shoes.
Hey, what's up? It's PJ Tucker, and welcome to my sneaker loft. The loft is primarily for storage. There wasn't enough space in my house to be able to put all my shoes, so I thought, you know, I gotta get a house. Probably have 700-ish to 1,000, depending on days. We have a bunch of shoes that are doubles and triples of some of my favorites. Honestly, it'd be kind of hard to wear them all. It's only so many days in a year.
This man has an entire house just for his shoes? What? I don't even have a house for myself. But we really get to see the darkest corners of his addiction when his team went on the road.
How do you really travel when you're on the road? And what are you really packing for a game?
So we got one of the best equipment managers in the game, Tony Miller, and he always takes care of me, making sure I got all my options and different things I want. You know, got the sneaker bag.
Let's check out the travel bag. Oh, man. This is kind of a duffel bag for a whole team, right?
Right, yeah. So this bag is made for like a whole team shoes on the road, but this is actually just for me.
How many pairs of shoes do you wear a game usually?
I've worn, I think, up to 6 pair in one game before, which wasn't by design. I don't know why people think I like try to like show off a bunch of shoes. It's really just superstition a lot of times. If the shoe's not feeling good, or you know, some of these older shoes I wear sometimes they break. You know, it just depends.
Hold on. Did you see that suitcase? How many pairs does he need for one game? Man, I've worn the same damn Skechers for years now. This is bullshit. Back to PJ. Y'all seen his suitcase. Y'all seen the house he bought specifically for his shoes. So, can you even imagine what his actual house looks like? Well, all right, you got me. It's not his actual house, but would you be surprised if it was? Here's the actual clip.
All right, so you definitely got a lot of stuff in here. How many pairs of shoes do you have?
It's hard to say. You know, I give away so many, but I'll probably say a few thousand.
What's the most you've ever paid for a pair of shoes?
Oh, that's a good one. Probably the Air Mag, just because it was for charity. That was a pretty big shoe, especially the second auto lace when they were going for so much. So it was like 36,000.
36,000 for the Back to the Future Air Mags.
What? He spent nearly $40,000 on one pair? Jesus, man. PJ has spent over $1 million on his addiction. This man needs help. It's clear to see why people call PJ the sneaker king. But do you know why people call John Wall Santa Claus? Well, the man is known for giving out some stupidly expensive presents. And in 2017, he really made his name for himself. See?
All right. So you get the picture, guys. And $36,000. I mean, like I said, that's a drop in the bucket for these guys who are making $40, $50 million a year playing ball. And can you imagine, though, the toll that it takes on their bodies to play all throughout the season, and the falls? Like, that amazes me when I watch. It's like, man, how do you just get out like so easily? I mean, I know that they get injured and stuff, but a lot of them will just play through it because they don't want to sit out in the game. I mean, did they still get paid the same amount? I mean, it is a contract. Yes. So they get paid either way.
Yes.
But they still want game time. So a lot of times they play through the injuries, right?
Yeah, sometimes. I mean, a lot of times the team will not let them play because, you know, the team's invested in them and they don't want them to make their injury worse just because their pride won't let them sit on the bench.
Now, how many games are left until the playoffs?
For my team, 7 games. But yeah, around 10 or less for most teams.
At this point in the game, you mean?
Yes.
Okay.
The marathon is coming to an end.
I am looking forward.
The playoffs start.
And the playoffs are going to be here right around the corner. Awesome. Can't wait. They're millionaires. Yeah, dust it off and count your money, says STL. And that's so true. They have like just an unlimited amount of money that they cannot ever spend in their entire life. And that's on a yearly basis that they are able to do this. But, you know, like what goes on in the NBA is that the people do not continue to play past, like, what's the age, like 30 or something, or even younger than that?
Mid-30s is usually the end.
Their max.
Yeah, mm-hmm. If you're 35 in the NBA, that's like considered geriatric usually. LeBron is a fucking anomaly. He's like 40 now.
Yeah, he's a beast out there. He's a truly amazing player. This is what they mean when they say the turn. Says Nat Claude 2.0. What does that mean? You don't know that the turn? I don't know what they're talking about either. What the hell is he talking about? What does that mean? I'm gonna put it up on the board and see if anybody else knows. Does anybody know what this means? I don't want to, you know, be all like, you know, I'm not on the same wavelength as Nat Claude, so I really don't want to ask him, but I will ask anybody else who is paying attention and who knows what he is referring to. What is he referring? Mm-hmm. All right. Link is, oh no, it's not. Link is dropped. I got a few minutes and then I'm going to get off here. I don't know who this guy is, but everything seems pretty cool to him. Pretty laid back kind of guy, I think. What's going on with this one here? Ask Brian King. He knows everything. Brian King is an amazing inventor. If you guys haven't met him, he has invented everything, including the cloth that you have on your body. He has invented shoelaces. I mean, I'm sure he helped to invent the light bulb. Who knows? He could have gone back in time. So he's the one, you know, if you have any ideas, he'll expand upon them and bring it to fruition. Nat Claude is absolutely fantastic. That's right. Two step. I'm going two-step. What happened to the lizard guy, Shells? I don't get it.
I have no idea.
What does she mean by that? You guys are stumping me tonight, totally. I think it's pretty cool that Lauren De Laguna stopped by. I think it's pretty cool that Ross Khan stopped by and Freaks. There's a lot of kind of new names who have not been around lately. So I think that's pretty cool, pretty spiffy. Sasquatch. Oh, yeah, Shelly's a flake. Or whatever he says. I don't know what happened to him. And sweet, that's exactly what I'm talking about, is that there's a lot of people who have just kind of disappeared. And maybe they went over to like another community or something, which I'm like, good. But I don't like to even put myself into a particular category when it comes to where I am on the internet, who I am on the internet. I just kind of hang out with the winners, the positive people. That's pretty much, you heard that Sasquatch passed away. Him or the lizard? Because, you know, there's a problem with people in this quote, the people we know, with disrespecting the dead. I don't think that's a good thing. I think it's actually a horrible thing. He died. Oh. Rest in peace, Sasquatch. Wow. Okay. Damn. I didn't know. Yeah, I read the chat. Sweet. I can't not read it. You guys have some really important information, and I did not know that. Okay. Wow. So, like I was saying, I don't like to put myself in a particular category. And I definitely don't want to be a part of a troll community or a drama community. Those kind of things don't place you in, you know, in a good light in society. And I'm all about being a productive citizen in society. And being a troll or being a drama king or queen just doesn't cut it for me, nor does it cut it for a lot of other people in the real world. And believe it or not, guys, you know, anything you say or do on here is applicable to being seen in the real world. I was looking at something. I was looking at the news, and I was like, "Mom, that's kind of messed up." You know, where you're on this like popular news channel, and then here's your face there because you did some kind of a heinous crime, and it's only you, and you're in a circle, and it's your face. So. Just kind of weird when you think about that. And that's like, you know, just try and be your best at all times. That's the fourth agreement. I want to let you guys know that my second agreement reading is still really taking off. People are listening to it on a daily basis. I think I'm up to like almost 1,200 views on that. So that's pretty cool. I'm glad that people are taking an interest in it. On a global level, because those are very important. If you can follow those four agreements, it will change your life. And they seem very simple, but they're very difficult to do because it's so easy to get defensive and take things personally. It really is. But it does interfere with relationships, and it sort of puts a wedge in between them. So if you guys want to carry on the legacy, maybe we can have a Sasquatch 2.0. Possibly. I wouldn't mind seeing that name around. He was a decent guy. We had some good little back and forth on the panels when I first started. And then after a while, he just kind of turned on me for whatever reason. That's what people do. So if people want to continue on with his name, that would be pretty awesome for the sake that his lizard, I wonder what happened to his lizard if he passed. I wonder if it went to another home or if it went to a shelter or something, or whatever they do. But I think his name was like Remy or something. I'm not exactly sure. Maybe you guys can remember. I think it started with an R. Bot clicks and views seems even cooler. Yeah, I wonder who you're talking about. Because I don't buy those. Yeah. Panels. All right, this guy is, you're patronizing me, sir. That's definitely. Rent is Ace's dog. Remney is Ace's dog. She said, whatever it is. Yeah, I'm just not interested. I don't know who that person is, really. I like, there's that lizard that I can't remember the name. He was really cool. He was huge. He had his own like enclosure. It was like a monitor, I think. Like a dinosaur. It's just enormous. Remington is a name of a blow dryer. Sweet. So pretty sure that's not the name. Sweet is an awesome person. We talk often. I don't care what people say about her because they're wrong. And for that, I don't appreciate. Torment, yeah. Aw, good grief. He doesn't have his daddy. That's so sad. Oh my gosh. Oh, Crocs in the snow? Oh yeah, that was real intelligent. This dude wore his Crocs while being in the snow. Yeah, they have holes in them and stuff.
Yeah.
Have you ever been in snow before?
Yes, I've been in snow.
Oh, I haven't, so I mean, I was just wondering, you don't have to. Yeah, I've got some Pop Rocks here. I guess it's about time to shut it down. I got distracted by my candy. I think I'm hungry, even though I ate Chipotle earlier and I pretty much split it, but I was still so full because I kind of ate a little bit of his because he didn't eat all of it. And now I'm looking for something kind of sweet. Go to bed, Shells. Oh, yeah, I could do that. That's a good idea. Mm-hmm. Wait, can y'all hear this? Hold on. Bet nobody did that on the ASMR videos. I'm gonna do that. I bet I could get millions of views for that. Pop Rocks ASMR. Hell yes! Oh my gosh, guys, I gotta go. I have a video to make. You're gonna love it. Hopefully my earbuds will be a sufficient enough microphone to use because they use some really sensitive, badass mics when they do those. What did GD say? Let's see. Sweet. Say that to my face, okay? How about you try that one? She said, you're old and need rest. I'm about to get real loud on somebody right now. Saying. GD is really cool. I like how you put it in all caps. Sweet, I think, is coming around when it comes to the cordiality that she has with him. And it's been really cool to watch, definitely. Okay, now you're just being patronizing, Sarsa Barilla. Who was the, who are you messaging for? You are the Pugface Media is here eating spaghetti, which is pretty cool. Hey, dude, are you mocking me? Do I say it's totally cool or do you just say that? Because I think maybe I've seen you in other places. I just don't remember. So, Bulletproof Tiger, we got Pugface Media here. He has three pugs. He actually has a leash that one of his fans gave him that split three ways. It's really cool. He'll go live stream. That's the one we were watching. Remember? It was the dog show where he was, and the dogs were trained to defend their owners and attack on command. So I did see that. You saw me in your chat, Pugface. That was really interesting to watch, and it makes me like want to go, okay, I want that, but I still want another pug. So pretty sure those two don't really go together, because pugs are like trained to be cute and cuddly, and to have a pug that would actually go after somebody on that kind of a level may not exist whatsoever. And that's a fact. Absolutely a fact. The title has been bringing people in, I think, the non-title title. I came up with that on my own, which was pretty cool. Gosh, now you got me saying it. Still thinking of the title name. I had a few ideas earlier that people were giving me, and I appreciate that. Just trying to find one that'll stick, even though the show's almost over. But I kind of want to show you this one. Okay. Two-step. Rodas Pop. Belly, Rodas Pop Belly. Rodas Pop Belly. What was that video that Corrosive Commentary put out today where it just said Rada and Binks, and then he had his intro and then there was nothing else? Does anybody know what that was about? That was super strange, even for him. And my title would have been Corrosive Commentary and Silver Thighs. That's what my title would have been. I guess I'm saying that and I meant it. All right, we'll take a look at this. This is my old pug. My radiant beam in the night.
Nice. Good. Nice.
So I did have a black pug and a fawn pug. I bought him from a breeder at the age of 8 weeks old. I brought him home in a milk crate. And I kept him until he passed away when he was 15 years old. So that gives people kind of hope that your pug can live a long life regardless of what they say. Now, I did adopt the fawn pug. Her owners they didn't care about her. They basically just let her live outside, and they are not outside pets at all. So one day I was just like, hey, I love your pug. And they said, oh, you can have her. So I took her and I brought her home. And now, you know, Pudgy had a friend. Her name was Rosie Girl. She lived to be about 12, I believe. And both, I mean, it's just heartbreaking to lose a pet. It just really is. It does get easier, and it helped me to journal, and I painted them. So those are the type of things that help me. And I just love them. I would love to get another one. And I thought about that as well, Pugface. I thought about that. And they're just, yeah, they're just precious. One, I had her cremated, Rosie Girl. With Pudgy, I brought him over to my dad's house because he has a pet cemetery, and he already had the grave dug and ready for me. And I was like, wow, this is a great closure. I have support. And we placed him in the at the burial with his favorite blanket. And we said a prayer. That was really nice. That was a good thing to do, for sure. He does sweet. He has a pet. He probably has like 8 dogs. And is that not weird? I forget the other types of animals. I don't know if he put a chicken out there or something. I'm not sure, but it seems pretty scary. Yeah, sarsaparilla, if you say that's pretty cool, it's not. Now, when it comes to the rabbit, he will be 8 years old this month. He's doing great. The only surgery or anything he's ever had is when he was neutered. So he's really healthy. And I have to know that, you know, nothing lives forever. So I've been kind of thinking about what I'll do with him. You going to bed? Yes. Hug your pugs and love them every single day with all your heart. Good night, pug face. And I hope you're still practicing. I have been a little bit, but I could do more. I have actually, pug face, I have an original song coming out. I've been working on it for 1 year and 4 months, kind of just trying to perfect it with the images, the editing, just trying to make it perfect, because I want this to be my best song. It's one that I wrote the lyrics. I didn't write the music. It's inspired by another artist. I don't know how to write music. I mean, I could, but it's hard. It's really hard. So anyway, look out for that. It should be coming out very soon. It has to come out this month. Sweet, that's not an emoji with him yawning, is it? I can't imagine you would do something like that. Changed the subject. I did, because I don't want to talk about taxidermying. I'm not hiding. Sweet. You listen, chill. If you want, that'd be kind of cool. We gave ours cremated because it's illegal to bury them. Jeez. Maybe you have a lot of floods or something. I'm glad that we can play like that, for sure. This is what GD said about the length of time that I have been kind of holding on to it and spending on it. And this was what he replied. GD said, after I said my original song is coming out soon, 1 year and 4 months project, LOL. He says, the Beatles wrote 14 songs in 22 days. Chip posts 14 pics in 22 seconds. I was waiting for Chip to give him a laughing emoji, but he did not. And instead, he posted a pic thereafter and said that he got beef ribs in the oven now and can't wait. So this guy eats good, man. Chip, if you haven't met him, you will see a healthy-looking man for sure right away. Swedish Sugar calls GD an old leprechaun, even though he's a Scottish Australian. And GD is actually 10 years younger than Sweet. So there's that. He will definitely put somebody in their place. He's been trying to put me in my place for 4 years, and we had a rocky start for sure, a rough patch for a little while, and it seems like things are turning around. He's lying. He's an old. Oh, ouch. Yeah. Yikes. Wow. Jeez. Unreal. Crazy, isn't it? Craziness. Flood insurance totally rocks, Dudette. It's D-U-D-E-T-T-E, by the way. Yeah, go ahead and say that T's are cool or pretty cool. That's great. So there's that seems so honest Abe. I don't see him here, but there you go. Sweet. Yeah, GD used to go on panels all the time. Okay, and he usually has a pertinent question in mind before he goes on a panel, which is pretty cool. I mean, he plans it out really nicely. I think I said I would just be on here for a little while, so I am going to keep my word and shut it down. Good night, Sweet. I hope you have a great night. Thank you for stopping in and busting my chops. Yeah. That was a long time ago. Things have changed, Sweet. People have publicly, embarrassingly disavowed their good friends online. And that saddens me because it makes me wonder, what was it all for? What was it all for? It was for the learning experience. That's what it was for. There are no mistakes in this world. Looking back at things that I thought were a mistake, I realized that it was supposed to happen. There was supposed to be some kind of a message that I needed to receive from a certain situation that happened. So, something to think about. What is it good for? Absolutely nothing. Good God. Night. Thank you.